present motion, and yesterday I have explained you the numericals on the average speed, average velocity, and now in the today's class I will start with the concept of rate of change of velocity. Students, when the question comes is of rate of change of velocity, when an object is moving along a straight path, straight direction, there is no question arises of changing the velocity. This is what? Straight path. But sometimes the motion may be along the curved path. So this along the curved path. So here question doesn't arise rarely. Question does not arise change of velocity, but in case of the curved path, so object at a point of curving has to change its velocity. So here the point of curving, so in these points the object which is in motion, so it has to change its velocity. So at the point of curving, so it has to reduce its velocity, and again it decreases, again it increases its velocity, and when again curving comes, it has to decrease its velocity, and again the velocity goes on increasing, and when the curving comes, again it has to decrease its velocity. So like that, increasing, decreasing of the velocity, it comes when the object is moving along the curved path. So that is at what rate the velocity it is changing, so called as a rate of change of velocity. Okay, this rate of change of velocity in when the object is moving along a curved path, or when the object is moving along a straight path, or when the obstacles comes in between the straight path, the object has to reduce its velocity. So in such situations, at that time the question of rate of change of velocity rises. The same rate of change of velocity is called as acceleration. Acceleration, the rate of change of velocity. That means change of velocity with time. Change of velocity with time. So that it is called as acceleration. Now, today's class, I will explain you about the concept of acceleration. It is defined as acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity of an object which is in motion. This is how the acceleration is defined. The one more question it will come, define acceleration. It is defined as the rate of change of velocity of an object which is in motion. The object has to be in motion, and it is denoted by, next it is, acceleration is denoted by English alphabet small a, and its SI unit is, its next term, its SI unit is, its SI unit is meter per second square. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. This is very important. Okay, and next is, question arises, how the SI unit is taken as meter per second square. So this can be explained like this terms. According to the definition of the acceleration, it says the definition of the acceleration, according to the definition of the acceleration, it says the change of velocity with time, change of velocity with time, with the time factor, change of velocity. So that is called as rate of change of velocity, is nothing but the acceleration. This is in the denominator side, I have written time, and in the numerator, change of velocity with time. That means the rate of change of velocity, the rate of with time, that is the rate of change of velocity, is nothing but the acceleration. And as I already here written, it is denoted by small English small letter a, and change of velocity, it is nothing but v minus u. V is final velocity, u is initial velocity, v minus u by t. Time is denoted by English alphabet, that it is t, v minus u by t. And now what I am explaining to you is that it is how the SI unit, so that is taken as meter per second square, and this is, as I already told, so V is final velocity. V means, that is, this is final velocity of object, and U is initial velocity of the object. So nothing but it is velocity. It is velocity factor. So that is when think u is 0, v minus 0 by t, then this equals to v by t, and that it is v is final velocity. And as I yesterday I have given the SI unit of velocity, it is meter per second, and SI unit of time, so that we already know the SI unit of time is second, and this is, and this it becomes meter by s into s, and this is meter per second square. So this is how the SI unit of acceleration, it came as meter per second square terms. And next is, sometimes what happens is the acceleration will be positive, and sometimes acceleration is negative. As just now I have given the formula to calculate the acceleration is v minus u by t. So this is a formula to calculate acceleration, v minus u by t. So this is what the formula to calculate acceleration. This is what the formula to calculate the acceleration of the object. So sometimes what happens is acceleration is in the direction of the velocity of the object, and sometimes it is in the opposite direction of the velocity of the object. So what I am saying is sometimes in some situations, sometimes acceleration will be positive and sometimes acceleration will be negative. And acceleration will be positive when, so let us take this is as a first case and this second case. In the first case, the question arises when the acceleration will be positive, when v is greater than u. When v is, that means final velocity is greater than the initial velocity, at that time a will be positive. That means that acceleration is positive, taken as positive. And in second, when v is less than u, then when v is less than u, at that time acceleration will be negative. Okay, this is it is acceleration it is taken. So this is what the formula to calculate the acceleration, v minus u by t. And sometimes acceleration will be positive and sometimes side by side acceleration will be negative. When v is greater than u, then a will be positive. That means final velocity is greater than initial velocity, at that time a will be positive. And time factor, it is always positive value only, it will not come in the negative. And when in second case, when final velocity it is less than initial velocity, so that at that time acceleration will be negative. So you have to be remember in these things. And next is it is said that negative acceleration of an object which is in motion is called as retardation. The negative acceleration of an object. So that is called as, with another word, retardation. Okay, this is all about the information regarding the concept of acceleration. So here in the acceleration, you have to be perfect in the definition and the SI unit and its formula. Okay, this is what the formula to calculate the acceleration. And this is also one more question, it will come on this. What is retardation? The negative acceleration of an object is called as retardation. So here, in case of the retardation, as I already told you, so that is v is less than u. So this is what the condition for the retardation. And on the acceleration, the numericals will come, and whatever the numericals on the acceleration, so those I will solve in my tomorrow class. And today I will stop the class with this much information. Thank you.